You over here, that must have mean you done went on down to the Canva and got the template, and you done brought it on over to either Design Space or Silhouette. Right now, we're working in Design Space, and I want you to see, we don't want to see no cracks. We don't want to see no cracks in there because we need to cut whole. Okay, we got our image in here. Now, we're going to resize it. We need to make it 4.568 in width by 5.511 in height. That's going to be the size that we need our box to be. And then we're going to go over here, we're going to grab a score line, and we're going to get, it's going to be four score lines for this size, but we're going to make it 3.62 in height. Once we get that, you can duplicate it and make your four right now. You can do it later. As you can see, I'm lining them up. I'm going to pull it on in so you can see, because we want it right on that line, because when we fold it, we want to make it easy to fold. There is no way for me to give you exact placement, because when it goes on your mat, it's going to be in different places. So you have to kind of play around with it as you see me playing around with it too. Each time I go in here, I have to play around with it when I want to start a new one. So you can see where I'm putting them. I'm going to put it right there on those, where those two reds, the slots are. And then I'm going to put it right over there too, where the glue line is. And we're going to get it in there. Make sure that our, it's right on there. We're going to, you know, play around. Like I said, play around with over where is the X and Y. That's where it's going to do it. Whatever. Then you're going to grab another score line. And you're going to go ahead and you're going to make that one 0.38. Yes. 0.38. And you're going to rotate that 90 degrees. Okay. You're going to put that one, line it up as we did the same thing, because you want to put it right there where it's going to fold. But you're going to put that all where you see all the green ones right here, or your little small tabs, if whatever you want to call them, that's where you're going to put those at. And once you get those all over in there, four of those again, it's going to be four, four of those. And you see, child, I'm filling and faddling around trying to figure it out, trying to get it on there, because we need it lined up real good to make sure it's going to fold, to make it easier to fold. Now, you do not have to do this step. If you're here and you're doing this step and you don't want to, you don't have to. This is just a personal preference of mine that I like to do, because I like just to make it easier to fold and it can be more even when you fold. Because sometimes, child, you get the folding cardstock and one side be up and one side be down and it be having all little wrinkles and stuff, like, ooh, you need some anti-aging cream. So we don't want to do that. So now you see I grabbed another score line and I made that one 1.67, and I rotated that one also at 90 degrees, because that one's going to go right here in the label, what is this called? The closing flap, the top closing flap and the bottom closing flap. That's going to give us what we need to do that. So we're going to do four of those right there. Okay. And line it on up. You got to, I'm very precise. Sometimes it's annoying how precise I am, because I spend too much time doing one thing that I didn't need to do. All right. So now we got everything together. So now what you see here is I went over there and I took the image out, so I can go ahead and group and attach our score lines to keep them together. So now then I bring it back in and I put our image in there, and I just make sure that our score lines are lining up all in there. So once we see that it's lining up all in there and everything's okay, we're going to attach that. So now our score lines are attached. So when we go to print and cut, you'll see it'll say, you know, print and cut score. Now, if you see here, you're only getting one in there. We don't want that. We want to make sure that we get our money's worth out of our product. So we're going to turn this to a 90 degree angle. Okay. That's the first step. Then the second step, we're going to duplicate that. And we're going to put two of them in there. And we're going to put them close enough. We're going to put them together and we're going to attach that. And the reason why we're going to do that is, boom, because now when we go over to make it for our printing cut, now we are getting two crayon boxes for the price of one. We know how I feel and we know how we love a good deal, okay? So once you do that, you cut it out, then we're going to go over and assemble these things. So now we done got it all cut out and everything like that. We're going to get it, and now we're just going to fold down where our score lines are, okay? Well, we made our score lines. Makes it easy. How easy that is? Ooh, it's like butter. It's like some warm butter on a hot biscuit, just melting away. It's folding. Yeah. So we're just going to go ahead and fold it down like that. All the little parts around. This part is probably the simplest out of everything. You probably spend more time trying to design it and move it around and all that other kind of stuff than putting it together. Isn't that how it always goes? You throw a party and you spend 50 hours setting up. Party go, and then in 10 minutes the whole, where all your decorations just ripped down. So anyhow, you see, on the side, you see where I put it says glue. So you're just going to go ahead and do what you're going to do. Let me see if you've been following me enough to know what you're going to do with that glue. You're going to slap that thing all around there. That's what you're going to do. Slap that glue all around that thing. You're going to get it on there real good. Now, what you want to do is when you fold it, you want to make sure it's kind of really, really flushed against it because you don't want any of the gray showing. So you want to make sure that you position it and getting it. You're going to see me reposition it a couple of times because I kept seeing the gray. And I'm so ticky. I wish I wasn't as ticky as I am, but I am. But you want to make sure you get in there and you flush it really good. You see, look at this. Just a whole mess, just readjusting and readjusting because I didn't like it. But yeah, make sure you get it on there nice and flushed and it's not showing any of the gray. And you're going to hold it down with your glue of choice, of course, as always, your glue of choice. Then you're going to go in, which my favorite handy dandy, one of my tongue depressors, you're going to go in there and smooth it on down to make sure it sticks real good. Now you're going to take your bottom flap right there in that part right there. You're just going to put a little bit of glue right there. Not a little bit, but enough a bit, okay? And you're going to slap it on around that thing, and you're going to slide it in there. Now, what I do is I hold it with my finger at the bottom, and hey, I get it in there. And I go inside. I'm showing you how I go inside, and I put it in there, and I kind of rub it against it and press it against there to make sure that it holds it to stick to there. And as you can see, I'm showing you on the inside. See? Bam, it's flat. So I go in there because something about me that's got to go do stuff over and over again. And then you fold that in and look. You are all done. Thanks for tuning in. See you next time. Pretty.